Well, everybody, it would seem the COD gods are blessing us today with a pre-download. There's still a lot of mystery behind this pre-download because it seems to only be happening on the PlayStation 4 as of right now. But if you go to your PlayStation, you'll actually be able to download update 1.24, which contains Season 5 and so much more. You can't install it right now. It's just a pre-download. That way you don't have to wait until 2 a.m., download 36 gigs, and then, of course, wait for it to copy over and then install so you're playing by 3 or 4 in the morning. The reason I say this update's a little bit mysterious right now is because not everybody is getting it, and I noticed that Xbox players have not been getting it either. I did see that some people were getting it as early as 2 in the morning. My update finally came through around 8 a.m. This is something that also isn't restricted to just the United States. I noticed some folks in the UK have been getting their updates as well. My little piece of advice would be resetting your PS4 and then doing a search for an update off of the application itself. And that tends to work almost immediately. It worked for me at 8 a.m. It worked for a bunch of my friends in the UK. And yeah, hopefully it works for you too. As for it coming to Xbox and PC, I don't see why it wouldn't. PC, I can kind of understand because of data mining. This is probably the update that contains maybe a little bit of inkling towards Call of Duty 2020, so they're trying to hide it as much as they can, but it's only a matter of time until people dig through the files. So I would imagine that the updates will be coming a little bit sooner than 2 a.m. on those platforms, probably on the same day. I don't know if it's anything to do with PlayStation exclusivity that PS4 got it today on the 3rd. Either way, I'm just happy that we got a pre-download. I'm hoping that they do this for all future updates, especially if they plan on releasing things at 2 in the morning. I really hated waking up at 2, downloading the thing, waiting for it to copy, and then being able to play by 3, 4. It made me feel like utter shit. So just hopping on and being able to play, that's going to be a great change. While we're on the topic of update 1.24, Joe Seacott did a little bit of a tease last night talking about an upcoming feature that people have been asking for since the launch of Modern Warfare. As we can see, AJ said, cut it close this time, Joe Seacott. Thanks for the content. Let's see some intel for Season 5 now, please. And he responds by saying, nicely done. I love to inspect these weapon challenges. Now, of course, as you can... Ow, my finger! Fuck! Now, as you can imagine, things have been a little bit crazy out there with Season 4 in the data mining community. They have recently found that there was weapon inspections in the game, only for a few select weapons. Well, with this most recent update, every single weapon has its own inspection now. So I would assume that Joe Seacott is teasing weapon inspections. Now, I don't think that we're looking outside of the box. I don't think that we're going crazy into outer space when we assume that he's teasing weapon inspections. Now, obviously, this would have had a lot more weight to it if we didn't already know that weapon inspections had slowly been added to the game over the past few months. But it's still cool to see nonetheless, and I'm very excited to have weapon inspections, especially because a lot of these blueprints deserve them. It was a feature that definitely deserved to be in the game since the launch. I didn't understand why, especially when there are so many different blueprints that at certain angles have different little designs and tidbits that you wouldn't normally see in a standard first-person perspective. It wouldn't be until you actually inspect your weapon that you would see all the little designs, unless, of course, you're looking at it within the gunsmith. But what's the fun in that? Don't you want to show off? Don't you want to do things in the multiplayer? Don't you want to play ground war and inspect your weapon and kill somebody really quick so they see that in their kill cam, or do something like that in search and destroy? Weapon inspection may seem minuscule, but it's actually very important for a lot of players out there that love that feature, including myself. I'm a huge fan of weapon inspection. So the fact that they're coming back, that makes me very excited. So another thing I'd like to discuss in this particular video is a small trailer that was released yesterday by Call of Duty. This trailer was almost like a recap of Season 4, except there were a couple of new scenes in there that just completely caught me off guard. So out of all of the data mines that we've had over the past couple of weeks with Season 4 and weapons that have been found, one of those weapons are the twin blades. This is different from the actual Cali sticks that we have. This is different from the combat knife. This isn't a blueprint. This is two blades that, of course, we see with Ronan's execution. And during this execution, there are two different frames that, honestly, you probably missed. If you blink, you'll miss it. That's how quickly they show up in this particular video. So at one point in the trailer, we see Ronan. And then all of a sudden, it cuts to this particular frame. This happens so fast that even when you're watching it in the slowest speed on YouTube, it's extremely quick. It passes so fast you might miss it even on the slowest speed. But honestly, what I think is happening here is while Ronan is out there fighting, he's channeling his inner samurai. I think that's exactly what's happening here. And they're just reflecting that through these images. But I really feel like it's much deeper because the images happen so incredibly fast. The average viewer of this video, it's not going to even notice that this is happening. Let alone the image that I'm showing you right now. That's what I feel like is happening. He's reaching deep and he's realizing his warrior's past, his samurai past. And then when he pulls out the twin blades to do the execution, then we get this image. This image appears for a little bit longer. I know that people want realism, but I want a samurai outfit like this. I would love to have something like that. I don't know, man. I think that this is definitely a tease pointing towards the actual blades that are going to be coming in the future. Because the first thing that they showed with the execution were the blades cutting to the samurai. I think that it is a small, subtle tease towards that, especially because we know that it's coming. I would imagine that it's probably going to be part of a mid-season update when we get the second weapon, which we're all kind of thinking is going to be the R700. If that does happen to be the case, I'm not against that at all. But the fact that these frames are just so incredibly fast, and it's the only thing that's out of the ordinary in this whole entire trailer, I just figured I'd point it out in this video. Oh yeah, and right here, since we've been talking about Sony's State of Play for the past few videos, Sony did announce that they're actually doing a State of Play on August 6th, but unfortunately, all the leaks that we talked about, probably not going to end up happening. They specifically said that it's a focus on upcoming PS4 and PlayStation VR games, a couple of check-ins on third-party and indie games for the PS5 showcase, but there's no big PS5 announcements. So that's kind of sad, considering everything that's been happening over the past month or so with PlayStation. We thought for sure that they were going to come out and announce a price with this particular State of Play. It also is very sad to know that the leaks probably aren't going to be coming true, and if they do end up coming true, it won't be until a later date. But anyway, guys, that's everything I wanted to talk about here in today's video. I hope you all enjoyed it. If you did, do me a favor, take a moment of your time to click that like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more awesome videos coming very soon, and if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. That way you don't miss a beat. I'll catch you all in the next one, guys. Peace.